In April, San Francisco's famed science museum, the Exploratorium, will reopen in a new building on the city's waterfront. The museum's West Gallery will focus on human phenomena. There, curator Hugh McDonald, a psychologist, is working on an exhibit called The Science of Sharing, which will teach visitors about competition, cooperation, and resource sharing.
Those phenomena are intimately connected with many of the major problems that the world faces today. Things like global climate change or resource depletion or international conflict, arms races, all of those are large-scale versions of small, intimate, you might say, social interactions, and giving people a chance to experiment with those we think will not only give them a chance to understand how the science of how human behavior is studied scientifically, but also the roles of individual behavior in larger world problems.
McDonald and his colleagues have designed interactive games and tasks that give visitors the chance to cooperate and compete with one another. Text phishing, for example.
The way this exhibit actually works is that people can just walk up, pull out their cell phone, and text the word fish to that particular number, and a boat pops up with their phone number on it, and they begin fishing. And essentially the dilemma we want to put people in is to balance out their own desire to catch more fish than the other guy with the understanding that if too many people fish selfishly, they're going to destroy the resource for everybody. And ideally, at the conclusion of the experience, they'd not only have had that visceral identification with the concept of the tragedy of the commons, but maybe motivated to think about what other situations in the world are like this.
In another part of the exhibit, visitors can try out a watery version of the classic prisoner's dilemma.
And this is essentially a two-person drinking fountain that's based on the idea of the prisoner's dilemma, which again is a situation where two people are jointly controlling their outcome and neither is quite sure what the other person is going to do.
Developer Chris Cerrito explains.
So the payoff structure of this exhibit right now is set up so that if you pick sip for the person across from you and they also pick sip, then both of you get a nice long drink. If you pick squirt for the person across from you and they give you a sip, then that person gets squirted directly in the face. And then if you both pick squirt, both of you get nothing, which is kind of funny to see.
McDonald and his colleagues tested parts of the exhibit at the Exploratorium's old home.
I've been very gratified to see a lot of visitors in these early stages be very excited that we're focusing on something that isn't just physical phenomena, light, sound, and motion, but that's focusing on something that they experience every day, that is their social interactions with other people and how they think and feel about other people.
Meanwhile, in another part of the West Gallery, curator Pamela Winfrey is putting the finishing touches on an exhibit called The Changing Face of What is Normal. The exhibit looks at the ways in which the definition of what is normal and how we treat those deemed abnormal has changed over time.
One of the impetuses for this particular exhibition was the fact that the Diagnostic Statistical Manual, which is the basic reference for all practitioners, anybody that's dealing with any kind of mental health issues, that's fifth edition was going to be published a month after we opened.
The multi-part exhibit will include information about the development of the DSM-5. It will also showcase artifacts from the history of mental health treatment, including a trove of patients' suitcases recovered from the attic of the Willard State Hospital, a decommissioned mental hospital in upstate New York.
So these suitcases, if you can imagine what it would be like if you did not know how long you were going to be gone, you didn't know whether you would have control over these objects or your own life for that matter, and you would select what you would bring with you, and that's what these suitcases are. So that to me seemed like a real heart, a place, a good heartful place to start an exhibition.
Visitors will also be able to see, and even climb inside, an antiquated restraint system called a Utica crib, once used in psychiatric hospitals.
It's not a replication because we know that there's no way that you could ever feel what it would be like to be in a crib like that for any length of time against your will. But if you could place people into an imaginative state where people would really start to think about what it could potentially have been like, that was our aim. It's a very personal show in terms that it's not mental health writ large. It's certainly not comprehensive at all. It's really about this idea that you would have an opportunity to sort of place yourself in somebody else's shoes. I think if this exhibition is successful, people will really start thinking about, my gosh, you know, I could have been those people.
The changing face of what is normal will be on display until April 2014.